If you ain't feeling it, film out. You know I just jump off the porch with Dirty Glove Bastard. You know that. Yes, sir, ski.
We right back at it, y'all. We got our family. Drew filmed it, jumping off the porch with us today. What's up, fam?
What's up, bro? How you been? About
3 years, bro.
Feels good to be back.
Yes, sir,
Still feels like the same home.
Yeah, come on, man. You already know, man. Make yourself at home, bro.
Facts.
You already know
it,
man.
Every door's open.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Man, how everything been, Drew, man? It's been
chilling.
A nice little minute, bro.
Yeah, I've been chilling, just enjoying life, bro.
Yeah.
Just waiting for Melly to come home, Hot Boy to come home, and I'm good.
Yeah, man. Come on, bro, man. Free to guys, for real.
Yes, sir.
For real. So, man, you in Atlanta. I know you're going to be speaking, or you're going to be over at the Trash Mag Collab Studios event,
sir.
Speaking to young up-and-coming filmmakers, right?
Yes, sir. I'm excited. I can't wait to meet everyone out there.
That's what's up, man. Yeah. Can you tell us a little bit about it?
I mean, I don't know too much, but basically a lot of videographers, really whoever wants to come out and, you know, just hear what I have to say, you know, just talking to people, kind of like, remember 5-6 years ago is when I was doing that. I'm just up and coming.
Yeah.
Any local artist, anybody that really wants to come, they can come. But this event's going to be cool.
No, that's what's up, man. And how important is it, bro, to give back and, you know, share game and share some of the knowledge that you've gotten over the years?
I think it's probably the most important thing that a creator nowadays or someone at a different level can do to the younger guys down low, you know? Because it's just like, you're looking up to these people, you want to hear what they have to say. You kind of, everybody's struggle is different, but we all do the same thing. So you never know if you could put someone's smile on their face today, and that's all that matters, you know?
Nah, for sure, for sure. Because when you coming up, you always, you know, a lot of times it's like, man, if I just got that one opportunity, man, if I could just talk to that person that's doing what I'm doing to ask them that one question or, you know, just get a better understanding of how they did it, you know?
Facts. I had questions I never had that opportunity to ask. But now I do, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I still want to ask those questions to some artists that I meet today, you know?
Yeah,
I used to watch you when I was in high school. Now I'm working with you. It's cool as fuck, you know?
Yeah, that's what's up, man. And how does it feel when people come to you telling you that, man?
It don't feel real, honestly. I just look at them as if I'm them. You know what I'm saying? It's just crazy. Like, I just posted on Facebook yesterday. I was like, I can't believe that someone ever asked me to autograph their shirt or some shit. Like, that don't make sense.
Yeah. Like, I mean, I saw you at the Tampa Bay Buccaneers game. Yeah. Like, you was there in the crowd signing footballs, jerseys, all that.
No,
like,
they show love. Shout out to Tampa.
Yeah. Nah, that's what's up, man. And it's crazy because, I mean, now, you know, you've put in so much work that, I mean, people are looking at you as OG almost. You know, I don't want to label you
you
know
what
I mean? But, you know what I mean? But for real, just respecting you as a veteran. I'll say it like that. You know what I mean?
100%.
How does it feel to even still be this early in your career, but then be respected, you know, as such?
It feels amazing. Like, I don't even know what to say too much about it. It's like a feeling that's like, you just feel, you know? I don't really know how to explain it.
Yeah.
It's just crazy to me nowadays.
And if you could tell Drew filmed it, you know, 5 to 7, maybe even 10 years ago, if you could give him some advice, bro, what would you tell him?
Watch out who you hang around with, probably, because that can also drag you down in many ways in life, to work, to really anything, girlfriends, you know?
But
at the end of the day, that's probably what's something I would tell him, because I'm still learning that same shit today, you know? So I wish I knew it back then.
Yeah, that's what's up, man. I mean, you know, hindsight 2020, you know what I mean? So it's like, we go through something, we experience it, and then the picture is so clear after the fact, but, you know, you got to bump your head, you got to go through these things to even be able to share the knowledge, you know?
100%.
Yeah, that's what's up, man, that's what's up. So, man, we just had YMWB Slime here.
Shout out Slime.
And it had been like, you know, he was talking to us about how he had taken a hiatus from music, how, you know, at a certain point, it just wasn't fun to him, you know, anymore. And just, you know, all the stress and different things, you know, that he had been going through and adversities that he was having to overcome.
Yes,
and then I saw you post something on Instagram talking about how, you know, it just wasn't fun for you anymore.
Yeah, I lost a lot of that fun just through, like, you know, labels, not paying. It's like, you do it for fun and you don't care about the payment, but it's like, when it's at that certain level, you just kind of expect certain shit. Like, you're supposed to, it's business at the same time. I've kept it real on my end,
for sure.
know what I'm saying? So I'm just, But yeah, like I just shot a video that we talked off camera, my boy EXO Trap. I just didn't have no fun for videos. I haven't shot a video in like a month. No one's paying. I'm still waiting on payments. So I was like, fuck it, bro. Let's shoot a video. You're a good friend of me. Let me give you this in return.
Yeah.
So yeah, we shot a video.
Nah, that's what's up. And yeah. That kind of takes you back like to the element of, you know, when you first started, I'm sure, you know, cause it's like when we first get started in this and we hungry and you know, there might not be a paycheck with it, but you being creative and thinking outside the box and doing things to catch the attention of the majors or of, you know what I mean, other artists. So it just, you know, makes you really like, you know, go in that bag and get creative. Yeah. Do you feel that dealing with what you were dealing with the labels and all of that, like, do you feel like at all, like at any point in time, you were ever compromising your creativity at times or?
Nah, sometimes I wouldn't, but I guess sometimes it's just like a yes and no question, you know? But I don't know, bro, like that label shit, cause it's like, bro, I do this shit, get it turned around in 24 hours.
Yeah.
And how the fuck it takes 2 years to get an email back. You know, I'm exaggerating, but yeah, it sucks.
Nah, I lose creativity off that. And I've been on both sides of it, having worked at the major labels. So I've worked inside the labels, then on the outside have done consulting, whether it be marketing or even, you know, I've put together treatments for music videos as well. So when you posted that.
That's another thing too. They be stealing the ideas on the treatments.
Come on now.
Like, bro, there's actual multiple videos. I don't want to say because obviously it's not the right thing to do. But
yeah.
Bro, I wrote treatments. 4 videographers go at it. Labels do that. Like they'll send a treatment out. And you have to send it back, and we're in competition with the 4 other videographers. I'm like, bro, if the artist doesn't want to work with me, I don't feel like I want to work with them because it's like it has to be a communication. It's like a team. You know what I'm saying? The chemistry got to be there.
Yeah.
So they would steal treatment ideas and use it for other directors to use it. And I'm like, I'm pretty sure I had the same idea, but I'll keep quiet. It's all right.
Nah, I could dig it. Hey, look, I was waiting to see if you were going to air out some dirty laundry because I got some dirty laundry too on the tip of where there's a music video out there by 2 very prominent artists where they literally took my treatment and gave it to another director. And I'm watching it like, okay, I know that y'all didn't just come up with this fool, you know.
I don't understand some shit in life. I ain't gonna lie. I just don't understand it. But that what makes them happy. I let them be happy.
For real. I think that's why too, a lot of artists, a lot of creatives, at times don't even want to deal with the major labels. You know what I mean? Because there's
so much. That's how I am now.
Yeah.
That's really how I am. Like, if a label hits me up, it's cool, whatever. But most of the time, the artists hit me up, and that just makes the chemistry off rip, you know.
Nah, for sure. Because a lot of times when you go directly through the artist with the artist, you don't have to deal with so much red tape.
After that, it's just brotherhood.
Right.
It's like we're supposed to, we know what we're doing, you know what I'm saying? So it's just like me and you. It's not 5-10 other people involved. And that's another thing. Communication in the industry will make you do a lot of fuck ups just because there's nobody's on the same point, you know?
Right. Nah, I can
dig it. I guess that's another thing I would tell myself, communicate better. That's another thing, because communication is key in everything.
And then too, I think the skill of being able to communicate in times of frustration, that's really key as well.
100%.
You know, not tapping into your emotions, not, you know what I mean? Because at times, you can, even if you're in the right, you could put yourself in a position where you could kind of get blackballed or X'd out of, you know, certain situations and miss out on checks, you know what I mean?
100%. So,
it's a skill with it, man, and it's difficult, you know what I mean? Difficult. Because when somebody playing with your money, when rent due, when bills due,
100%.
And you did the work and the video's getting millions of views.
I get my all. Like, I get my 200%, why can't you give yours?
Right.
Oh, well.
Nah, I mean, you know,
that's just how I feel. It's just like,
sure. And it's a part of it, man. It's like, those is a part of them, like, welcome to the music industry moments. You know what I mean?
And it's like, you kind of see who you want to do business with and who you don't. Like, if that happens, I'm never going to shoot another video again. So it's like, now you're going to waste my time with that shit.
Yeah, nah, I can dig it. Now, when you took your break, was there like an intended time for it, or were you damn near stepping away from doing visuals? Like, what was the thought process?
It's not like I just wanted to step away from visuals. It's like, you know, I was kind of enjoying my life in a way, you know. I took a little break, But at the same time, all the mental thoughts from the labels and all that shit was going on. So it's like, you know what, I'll just take a bigger break. Yeah. I unfollowed everybody on IG just cause. And then motherfuckers got mad at me for unfollowing, but it's like, bruh, you have my phone number, like call me. Like it's not even that big of a deal. I have zero. Nobody's looking in the world
right
now.
Nobody.
Like not even my girlfriend's followed.
So
it's just funny how people even view shit like that, you know?
And during this break, did you learn some things about yourself or did 100%. You discover some things?
Think before you do shit, you know, make sure you have a close team around you. And if it's just you and one person, you and that person run the world, you know?
Yeah.
It's our world. Everybody's, it's their own world. So
yeah.
Just make sure your world is happy and peaceful and you have your family right there next to you, you know?
Wow. Nah, that's what's up, man. And what were you doing during this break, bro? Like, were you, did you pick up any other like hobbies or skills? Or
I'm at a close friend. We met through the music industry too, but you know, he does the rentals and shit like that. So it's like, I learned a lot from him because he does. For this man to make so much money selling Pokemon cards, I didn't even know it was a such thing. Like, he's chilling at the crib all day making money. I'm like, I'm gonna learn about Pokemon now. I miss out my childhood. Like, I need to know this shit. But yeah, I learned a lot of different shit. That's one of them.
Yeah, no, that's what's up, man. I mean, you figure, I mean, when you start learning about these different areas where people are making money and making money while they sitting down, while they sleep.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like that's where it's at, because if we gotta work and step out to get every check that's coming to us, I mean, that's so much, you know what I mean? Like
different incomes too.
You say what?
Different incomes.
Yeah, nah, for sure. Gotta have them multiple sources.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. So YMW Melly video Risk Taker just dropped a few weeks ago.
Yes, sir.
And I mean, it's dope seeing, you know, footage of him, like, just being happy and vibing and all that, you know what I mean?
I'm glad I gave you that, too, because that was kind of the goal.
Yeah.
It's like, you miss him watching that, like,
yeah,
it brought back, like, good vibes, like, 2018 vibes, like,
yeah.
And it was, like, never seen before footage, so it was, like, cool for, like, the fans to really engage in that.
Nah, for sure. And What was like going through your mind as you were, you know, piecing together this content, making it? Because I know it brings back so many memories.
Bro, let me tell you, bro. When I'm sitting there going through the files, I'm just like, bro, I didn't even edit it for a good week. Huh. I'm watching all the clips. I'm just replaying that bitch, watching it again, smiling. Yeah. I'm like, bro, them probably is like the best moments of my life, you know? Like,
yeah.
So them moments gonna come back though.
Yeah, nah, for sure.
We gonna remake those.
For sure. And do you still talk to Melly? Like, are you in touch with him?
I mean, it's hard just cause the situation, but it's really just through lawyers, you know, letters and shit, so.
Yeah, cause you know what? I do remember B Slime was saying that like it's more through letters and can't really talk on the phone too much. And
he got zero phone, like nothing, no zero phone, and you just talk to the lawyers, but it's not even like a message. It's just like the lawyer saying like, the same shit. It's like, bro, I want to physically talk to you, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's different hearing a voice from a message than in real life, you know?
Yeah, nah, for sure. Man, hopefully the fans sending them letters and, you know what I mean, people 100%. Like helping him.
We can send him pictures too.
Yeah,
okay. So he get pictures and shit.
Okay, word, that's dope, that's dope. So he can like still, you know, be in the mix of like what's going on the outside. 100%,
but it's not every day though. That's the thing that sucked.
Right. Like, right. Yeah, man.
I don't understand that shit. I don't understand.
Yeah, man. Free the guys, man. For sure. For real. And Boss Man D-Lo, man, this cat been going crazy over the last couple of months. And you actually shot the Finesse video.
Yeah, shout out to D-Lo. He going crazy. I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah, nah, for sure. And it's dope because we had him here on the porch like right before, you know what I mean, the surgeons.
But I think it was the same trip we shot that. I think he did an interview here.
Oh, okay.
I think. Wait, how long ago was it?
I mean,
I think he was
2 months ago. Like,
yeah, it was around that time.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was the same Atlanta trip. He was here for a week. I think that was.
Okay, word.
Yeah.
Nah, that's what's up.
So we was on the right timing.
Yeah, man.
Look.
Nah, man. We always linked in. Always, thanks. You know what I mean? Nah, man. So and you know, working with him, did you see like where it was gonna go? You know what I mean?
I mean, he had the buzz that the day we shot the video. I think they dropped the Instagram clip of the viral freestyle, and that like took off, and I think we're like, it's in the vlog, we did a vlog and we're looking back, he's like, oh yeah, it's doing this amount of views, and we're like, what the fuck, like, oh yeah, you off.
Yeah,
I was telling him when we're shooting, I'm like, yeah, this bitch gonna go
out of there.
And it was just so cool because it was like we had ideas, we talked about it, but then when we got there we kind of worked together and like thought of the ideas together and like what made more sense doing it, and it was cool. So he was on top of his shit, you know.
Word. Nah, that's what's up, man. So I feel like most people, you know, attribute you or connect you to, you know, Florida artists.
Yeah.
But then you've been shooting videos with Fredo Bang. I know y'all dropped some early in the year.
Yes, sir.
And then even Young Scooter and Future's video, like that, you know what I mean? You shot that. Like, mm-hmm. how has that been even being recognized outside of Florida and respected, you know, by these other artists to, you know, want your vision?
It feels cool because it's like I never thought I would even have to take a plane to go to work, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Now it's like I'm cool, I'm chilling with them, and it's like they're hitting me up, like Scooter and all them boys, they hit me up, and it feels cool, like someone from out of state like sees what I'm doing miles away, you know?
Yeah, nah, that's ill. And then Future and Lil Durk video. Now,
I forgot, I had to think.
No, because the visual is so dope, though, because y'all did like a Mad Max thing.
Yeah, because that was the name of the song, and that was kind of like one of Durk's ideas, like based off the movie. But that's all they gave me, based off the movie. So I had to watch the movie multiple times, and like we actually used the real location from the movie.
Oh, wow.
The Jamaican spot in the same music video.
Yeah.
So that was cool.
Oh, wow. Nah, that's crazy. That's dope. And what was that like? What was that like working with those guys and even just, you know, on something, like doing something so creative too, you know what I mean?
No, it's always good and they're cool. Like I made it very easy for them too. Like with artists like that, you only got an hour or two because they got a lot of shit going on. So it's like, you gotta make it easy for them and just get the point across, you know? And they were cool. We was on set for a couple hours and everyone stayed, everyone vibe, we chilled and everyone was down for each shot. So that was a blessing, so.
Yeah, no, I can dig it, I can dig it. And do you prefer, shooting, you know, like run and gun videos or maybe not so much?
I feel like
I remember in your first interview here, I think you were talking about like.
I always aim for run and gun.
Yeah.
Always. Cause it's like, I'd rather stay like on the road with you for a week and kind of show your lifestyle cause it matches your music. So if you live in your lifestyle and it's in the music video, it's like, and you're talking about a song, everyone relates to it, you know?
Yeah.
And it's just like, you know, like YouTube, when you go to YouTube, a lot of people watch vlogs and like want to know behind the camera. So it's like, if you get those type of shots and make it look like, you know, like a Rod Wave vlog
or
a music video, he just has clips of months of times. And it's just so interesting to watch. You want to replay it.
Yeah, yeah.
And then makes you like the song more and, you know.
Nah, for sure. It's almost like it gives you like a visual documentary.
100%.
But with a soundtrack over it, you know what I mean? So it's like you're not catching the BTS of like the audio, but you're catching all the visuals and what's happening over the music. Yeah,
makes it interesting to watch because a lot of people just put YouTube on the TV and let the bitch ride all day.
Yeah.
So it's like they can watch it at the same time.
Yeah. So what inspired you to come back into shooting visuals and what, you know, brought that spark back to you to make you want to, you know, tap back in?
I mean, I always have love for videos. That shit never gonna go away. I'm always gonna have a camera in my hand, but just, bro, shooting with my friend that day after taking that break, and now just like, bro, it's fun. Like, I literally did it just to have fun again doing it, you know? And, yeah.
Nah, I can dig it. And 42 Doug just recently got out, but I know even before he had went in, y'all had shot that Spin It Back, right?
Yeah, yes, sir. We had shot that shit here in Atlanta.
Oh, okay, word.
Yeah, it was fun.
Yeah. Nah, man, Doug, he seemed like he just, you know what I mean, has like that energy, you know what I mean? Like,
and like in music.
Yeah, for sure. Nah, I can't wait to hear like some of his new stuff that he coming with too.
He played some shit the whole trip, bro. He has some shit.
Yeah,
he needs to put that project together ASAP, I ain't gonna lie.
We definitely need that, man. Like the streets want to, you know what I'm saying, they want to hear that. So, man, you were in a serious car accident a few years ago too, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
was a crazy night. Yeah.
What happened? What?
It was just some shit that happened in a club, don't even know, but fucking we was leaving, got into a car accident with like three other cars, flew into a pond and rushed to the hospital. Like I was laying on the floor and like my friends have a video of like I was just laying on the floor after the car accident. The whole sidewalk was filled with blood.
Wow.
And I was like in the ambulance and I woke up in the hospital. It was a crazy experience, bro, but I'm just blessed I'm here, you know?
Yeah.
You learn from mistakes, you know?
Yeah, nah, for sure, for sure. And, you know, when you were going through that, like what types of thoughts were going through your head, man?
I don't know a thing. Huh. I don't remember a thing. Yeah. I don't remember. You talking about from that night or just like afterwards?
Just afterwards, you know what I mean? Like what was kind of, you know, going through your mind?
You definitely think before you go outside the house, for sure. Yeah. Every time I go outside, I'm like, is it worth it? You know, like, I'll probably have more fun here just chilling if, you know,
but,
because you never know what happens. And I've even been like laying off liquor and weed too, like a little bit just to like think before I do shit, you know?
Yeah. No, I can dig it. I can dig it. As you grow in your career, as you know, you become more of a boss, having, you know, even, you know, people underneath you, I'm sure that like those, you know, just being on point and then even being a better leader, I'm sure like that resonates with you when you make different moves.
You have to be a good leader for sure.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Is there pressure? Do you feel pressure in terms of, you know, like where you're at in your career and how people, you know, may view you and you know, just what you're doing? Like, do you feel pressure to, you know, produce like more content and more, you know what I mean?
At the end of the day, I'm gonna be myself. I'm happy in life. Like, I built all those years grinding and shit. I built a life where I don't really give a fuck about anything. I'm already happy. Like, I already found what I need to do for the rest of my life.
Right.
And that's just to chill. Like,
I can dig it.
Have family, have people around you, and you just live life every day. I don't really feel like all that extra shit is need to be worried about, you know?
Yeah. And so outside of money, like, what are some things that fulfill you? What are things that make
like
you
happy? Like hobbies and shit?
I mean, just anything, bro. Because, you know, it's so easy when we ask somebody, you know, what makes you happy? What drives you? It's like, man, getting to the bag, you know, but it's like, all right, you know, you got all the money in the world. All right, what are some things that would fulfill you and that would, you know, make you happy besides spending the money?
Yeah, I was gonna say, because one thing is, like, I love gifting people shit.
Okay, yeah,
like,
for sure.
I just bought, like, my friend, like, he just got a home, so I bought him all shit for the house, like a blanket, and he was like, and like a motivational sign above the studio, and he was like, bro, like, that's better than any fucking thing you could ever give me, because at the end of the day, he reads that message every day, and he's like, I'm gonna read that message every day and think about some shit, because that's like some motivational shit. But I'm gonna say that, bro. It's just so fun seeing someone so proud, and you get a text message like, bro, thank you so much. Like, sends a picture of it. It's just cool as fuck.
Yeah. You know? Nah, I can dig it, man. Have you thought of a gift that you would give Melly when he finally comes home?
I haven't. I actually haven't.
Word.
But a big ass hug.
Nah, for sure.
For sure, big ass hug.
Nah, man. I know that's gonna be a movie when bro come home.
Yeah, I know. I just know the moment's gonna happen. I'm just waiting for it.
Yeah. I know it has to be frustrating too with, you know, the way that his trial is going. I know there was a mistrial, but then now they're basically starting like the trial process all over again.
Yeah, the prosecutor had got fired, witness or some shit. Like, bro, if that don't tell you everything, then
right.
I don't, like I said, I don't understand that shit, bro.
Yeah, it's like to have to go through a trial all over again after they've already found that, you know, there's been tampering.
Yeah.
It's like how
is it ever gonna be equal?
Right.
Cause nothing happened, bro. Straight, like, that should just prove everything, you know? But
no, for real.
I'm one person to the world, so.
How do you deal with, because I see a lot of people, you know, in the comments, and even you post stuff, you know, about like people trolling and all that. Like, how do you deal with the online trolls? How do you deal with the haters?
Because like our question earlier, like, I just don't give a fuck. Like, people, like, there's so many times where I see shit and it's like, I go to their page and I type up like a whole shit, like on some funny shit and just gonna roast them. I'm like, bro, I'll just delete this shit because it's not even worth it. Like.
Yeah.
I just think it's funny, like the trolling and all that shit, because at the end of the day, I'm still gonna smile.
Yeah.
Like, I don't give a fuck about what you have to say, like, so.
Yeah, nah, I feel like when you feed into it, that more, I mean, shit, that make the folks troll even more, so.
You know, it's so funny you actually said that, because on Facebook, they have like a fan thing, and this person that says under the comment on my post, she flamed me. She was like, I don't even know why you're famous. So I clicked on the page, but it says she's my number third fan. So wow. I screenshotted that and just replied to the comment. I'm like, it's kind of crazy to say that when you're my top third fan, but thanks. Like, love you too. Like, it's just so funny. Like,
and then it'd be crazy when you see the folks that's trolling and then you go and click on their profile. They got zero posts. They don't even have a profile picture or, you know what I mean?
It's probably one of your friends.
Right, for real.
Someone you know.
That's usually how it is. You know what I mean? For real. Who are some artists that, that you would like to work with or shoot some visuals, you know, with that you haven't yet?
There's this artist coming out of Miami, bro, and he's blowing the fuck up right now. GTW Mike, Meek, I forgot how to pronounce it.
Word.
But he's hard, bro. He has a song, bro. He's like in the next Juice WRLD. They compare him to,
Oh,
you know?
Word, okay.
But yeah. he went up like 100,000 followers in the past couple months.
Shout out to bro.
Yeah,
nah, that's what's up, man. That's what's up, man. And what other artists
too?
Yeah, yeah. Like what? Like any major artists that you haven't worked with yet, or that you aspire to work with?
I want to do like a Luke Combs, like country shit. Cause I did one country artist, but okay. Luke Combs, I just see how he is on TikTok and like how he is as a person. I'm like, bro, I'll fuck with that. Like, yeah. I want to be your friend, you know? Like, he's one, but I'm trying to think hip hop. Probably Wayne, but that's like a obvious answer.
Hey,
like,
but I mean, yeah. we manifesting up here, you know what I mean? So that's what it's all about.
No, do like a Paul Wall.
Yeah, that would be
Paul
crazy.
Wall, just because everyone says I look like him. Just I have to do it.
Yeah, no, just for have sure. to. Come on, man.
Paul Wall, come on now, bro.
Yeah, let's make that happen for real. Hey, and then you see, so we saw Juvenile and Manny Fresh drop a video for 400 Degrees. Mm-hmm. I'm hoping that you know starts a trend of artists going back to their classics and you know.
I just seen that shit. Like they said, how 20 years later?
Yeah, yeah, like 15, 20 years later.
And they dropped it. That shit going viral. And that shit paying them again. Crazy. It's smart.
Yeah,
they smart.
And for a lot of us, bro, like that song was one of our favorite songs, you know what I'm saying, on that 400 Degrees album. Like Juvie has so many quotables on that song.
Yeah, it was before my time, but I still know.
Hey, no, it's all good though. All right, so to put you on the spot though, there any classic songs that you would, you know what I'm saying, like to do a music video for, if you could? And any old favorite of yours, you know what I mean? It could be anything.
Probably like Eminem Mockingbird.
Huh.
On some shit like that. Yeah. But that's so personal. Like, he just got to leave it where it's at.
Yeah. Nah, I can dig it, man. Nah, I really hope that become a trend, though, because
I think it's great. I literally just shot by Diesel.
Yeah.
I literally texted him. I swiped, because he's the one that posted it, and I swiped up. I was like, bro, we got to do that shit. And I'm going to see him today, so I'm going to talk to him about that
That's
shit.
That's what's up, man. Yeah, that's what's up, man.
That's so smart.
Yeah, it's the illest thing, man. Like, I wish it's for the
culture, you know?
Yeah, for sure. Like, man, I'm a huge Devin the Dude fan, so it's so many classics from Devin that I wish that, you know, that could be remade. So, hey, maybe that's something that we got to manifest and make happen, you know what I mean?
let's hope.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. What else you working on, man? Like, what else you got going on that you excited about these days?
I just did some shit with Sexy Red. That's waiting for that shit to be dropped. But other than that, same shit. I just be chilling.
Yeah,
I'm just chilling.
Speaking of Sexy Red, though, you know, that makes me want to, you know, tap into the whole subject of there's so many men who feel like they can't be fans of these female rappers or just got something to say about, you know, the message like in their music. And
when they doing the same thing as a guy, though.
Yeah, so you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, it's such a, you know, it's so crazy because it's like
you hear a Sexy Red song in the club, the first person playing to it, dancing to it, is a guy nowadays.
Right, right. You know what I mean? But nah, how do you feel about just the, you know, just the women in hip hop just killing it? And
I think
and
it's cool. I mean, just don't let my girlfriend act up, and we good.
Right.
But I support it. Yeah. They doing their own thing, you know.
Yeah. Nah,
and it's cool because it's like. There was like a year ago, it was like back to back, just out of nowhere, females popping up.
Yeah.
And I was like, it's cool to see. It's not just only guys either.
Yeah,
you know?
Nah, for sure.
They're branding off.
Nah, I'm liking that too. And then I see people trying to say that, you know, the woman era in hip hop is starting to die out. But I just think that's just,
it comes and goes.
Yeah.
It comes and goes.
Nah, for sure, for sure. Anything else that you working on that you want to tell us about?
I mean, just staying focused on them YouTube vlogs, just trying to, you know, brand out and do that shit too, because a lot of people want to see behind the scenes.
And that's been really dope, man, because you've really, you know, we always see behind the scenes of the artist. And I mean, your BTS is also of the artist, but it's truly seeing the BTS of you doing what you do, which, you know, is a whole nother element of it because, you know, for aspiring filmmakers to be able to even see like what that process is like, to see that it's not easy, that you're not just going out there with the camera and just doing it, but there has to be some organization. There has to be, you have to be creative and you have to be organized and disciplined, you know, to be able to do it.
It's also cool too, cause like a lot of people, like they don't understand too, like when they see the music video, they're like, I shot it, but it's like, I'm actually there really chilling with them too and like experiencing everything with them too. So it's like kind of cool to even have that memory for myself,
Yeah,
you know?
What inspired you to want to step from behind the camera to also showcase yourself and be in front of the camera?
I mean, shout out to Track, because, you know, he always told me that camera's never going to be in your hand forever. Like, of course, I love videos. I'm going to have it in my hand. But realistically, he's like, bro, you're not going to hold that camera for life.
Yeah.
And he was one thing that put it in my head. So I started doing the YouTube vlogs. And then, you know, I'm friends with a lot of YouTubers, Baylen, D'Adrian, and all them. So they're already up there and they're YouTube veterans. So it's like, I just look at them like,
yeah,
I want to be like you now, you know?
Yeah, for sure.
And they look at me like, I want to be like me. So it's like, it's cool as fuck to just have that chemistry too with them.
Yeah. No, that's dope, man. And then to, you know, be in a position with people that you may look up to or people that you just respect their crafts, and then on both ends, you're able to inspire each other.
Yeah.
Like, that's the best types of relationships to be able to have, where no matter the age, no matter the level of where we're at in terms of working, you know what I mean? Being able to inspire each other, like, that's the dopest thing to have and keeps us with that good energy to keep creating, you know what I mean?
100%. Yeah. Definitely agree on that.
Yeah, no, that's what's up, man. Man, you got any shout outs or, you know, say anything? Any shout outs before you get
on? You know how I always do it. Drew ain't filming it, film right, free Melly, free hot, you know that.
Yes, sir. Drew filmed it, jumping off the poach. One more game. Let's get it.